Welcome to sunny Winter Haven, Florida. I'm Lane Dog Bowers, and today we are going to be talking about a tower boom installation on a MasterCraft X2. It's actually a 2012. The tower we're going to be installing it on is actually a ZFT4 tower from MasterCraft. Beautiful tower. I'm in beautiful sunny Winter Haven, Florida in my dream home over here that is actually for sale. For any of you guys who see this and just fall in love with this beautiful house, it's the most beautiful house in Winter Haven, and this is where we decided to do our backdrop for this, the MasterCraft X2 boat with the ZFT4 tower. Now listen, if you're seeing this video and you go, hey, I don't have a MasterCraft X2 with a ZFT4 tower, don't worry. You know, the bottom line is that as far as booms go, we have a boom to fit every boat, and we've got a tower boom to fit the tubing of every wakeboard tower. And if you're watching this and wondering what we're even talking about, the goal here is that we want to add as much value to you as we can by showing any of you out there who want to learn to water ski, wakeboard, slalom, or our favorite barefoot water ski without falling at ridiculously slow speeds, the easiest way to do it is on a boom. And today we're talking specifically about a specific boat and a specific tower that a lot of people didn't know that you could put a tower boom on. So I'm gonna be handing this camera off and we're gonna get rocking and rolling. All right, here we go, you guys. Here is how your tower boom comes out of the box. We've actually gone ahead and done a couple of things to save time, but let me kind of go over what we got here. We've got our master clamp, which is the main bottom clamp that's going to hold the boom. We've got two clamps that are going to mount on the first section of the boom, and we've got two tower clamps that are going to mount on the tower. Now with this specific boat, a lot of people don't realize that tower boom works awesome on this boat. This ZFT tower is a beautiful tower. It's got one set of tubing in the front. So what we're going to do is we're going to show you how to mount that, where to put the clamps, how to angle your boom to get out of the chine spray. Because on these boats, chine spray, if you don't know, is the spray that comes off of the side of the boats. As the boats get bigger, it's harder to get out of the chine spray. There's a couple ways to get out of the chine spray. You either got to angle your boom forward, which we always recommend, or you can use a boom extension. With this boat, with this application, we're going to talk about getting the perfect angle of the boom forward, and then we're going to go from there. So we're going to show, I'm going to hop in the boat and show you how the clamps go, the main boom clamp, the two tower clamps, and then we'll go from there. One. All right, here we go, guys. We're in the boat here, and what I want to talk to you about is the different pieces. This is the master clamp. The master clamp goes on the lowest possible part on the rear leg of the tubing of the tower. Most towers have a front leg and a back leg. This tower, the ZFT4 tower from MasterCraft, has just this one piece of tubing. So what tower boom? We got the perfect tower boom for that. So all we're gonna do is talk about how to go through this. And to save time, we've actually mounted the boom clamp already. But here's what a boom clamp is. All this is simply two pieces of aircraft aluminum that come together, and then the next piece portion of the boom is secured with this easy locking pin, just like that. And we've got two bolts that'll stay on there. And then what we've done is we've gone ahead and installed that right here. Why did we choose this one particular spot? What we found out, we saved you all the trouble of trying to figure out where to mount this on this particular tower. We could have mounted this lower, we could have mounted this higher. We decided right here because it allows for the perfect angle so that we can get the right angle coming out of the boat to allow the skier to get out of the chine spray. This exact angle, which we've set up right here, which you can see roughly how it is, but you'll have to, as you're putting this together, you want about two or three people to help you out. But what we did is we kind of set it up a little bit and then backed out of it to explain it to you. All we have is these two bolts. And by the way, all the tools for this come included with it. We got some wrenches here. I'll show you here. Steve will hand them to me. These come with it. Look at this right here. All the way with it. Here's the other one. And so what we do is these two bolts mount it right here. This is the quick releasing pin that we're going to put the first section of the boom to, which is this section right here. So what we'll do is we'll put this section, I'll mount into here. We've also gone ahead and mounted on the boom clamps. These two clamps right here, we have two telescoping arms that we're gonna put that will come to these tower clamps. Now the tower clamps, we've also found the perfect spot where these will go over this arm without hitting it. We got another one that goes right up here, so you can kind of see if you got this tower, mount this one all the way up here, and mount this one just off of this weld right here. You can see the angle right here. It's angled forward. We'll show you that a little more. And then the main boom, or the top main tower clamp, this is for a different diameter tower, but these mount right here and here. They have, you can see right in here, they've got four, what do you call them, Allen keys?
Socket head screws.
Yeah, socket head screws. I'm not much of a mechanic. I just know how to put these things together. So there's four socket head screws. Again, we got the Allen key wrench that goes with it. They're real easy to mount. You just got to make sure you leave them loose while you first put them on so you can get everything adjusted. That's why you need a person outside the boat kind of holding it. And then these are, here's a look at what the screws like. These are the clamps. There's two of these that mount right onto the first section of the boom. So that's it. There's all your clamps. We got the position right here of where we're doing. We got the main boom clamp here. This is the right height. You can see right there, about, you know, about size of a fist right there off of this weld right here. This section about the same distance right here, and this clamp all the way at the top. And now we'll get ready for the next section of putting the two sections of the tower boom together, and I'll talk to you about the right angle that you got to have to get everyone out of the spray. So I'll talk to you outside the boat in just a second. Okay, here we are outside of the boat. These very beefy stainless steel arms are awesome, and what they are is they're adjustable. So what I recommend you doing is, this one we've got, you know, we've got probably 12 inches apart. You can kind of guess, it all depends on where you put the arms on the tower boom. But what I recommend for one of them is that you take this and you want to screw these all the way out till you see the dimples at the end of this piece here. Screw this one all the way out till you see the dimples. Come in at least an inch and a half in from there, maybe even 2 inches, and that'll be right. So now, once you've got one of them all the way out and one, you know, roughly for where we're going to have it, maybe 12 inches apart like that, you're ready to set these up. And all of this, you got to realize, you can't set it up perfectly like we did. You're going to have to actually set it up a little bit, experiment with where the distance of the clamps are going to be, and then adjust these arms to get them just right. We're going to have to take a little break here because of the rain.
Yeah.
Okay, one thing I need to mention is, for those of you who are not familiar with the tower boom, I need to explain a little bit of difference. A pylon mount boom is a boom like in a ski boat, like a mid-engine direct drive or a V-drive that has a pylon in the rear of the boat. That's a pylon mount boom. We have a special boom just for that, for a mid-engine direct drives, several of them. Another one for a V-drive, like this one, but for a V-drive with no ski pylon, but that has a tower, we use a tower boom. One thing different, now listen, if you don't have either of those boats, don't worry about it, because we got a boom that'll fit any boat. But for those of you that are familiar with a pylon mount boom, one thing that's different on a tower boom is it's a little more work to put on it from a standpoint of, after you do this installation, maybe takes 4, at the most, 5 minutes, that at most, to put on a boom once it's been installed. But you, whenever you do a tower mount boom, it's not as easy. You can't like just go in the middle of the lake and set it up. Ideally you want to be pulled into a dock or on a beach, so you can get, right now we're setting it up on the boat trailer, but that's not where you'd normally do it. You want to be at either a beach or dock, so you get some sure footing on, because these next part, we've got two arms that come down, and now that leads perfectly into the next section, which I'll hop into the boat, and then we'll go from there. Okay, guess what? We've got our main boom clamps installed, or the first boom clamp installed. We've shown you where to put these two tower clamps. Now we've gone ahead and saved the trouble. There's four screws in each of these, but we've kind of already figured out roughly where these need to be on this. And the easiest way to do this is to get a couple people helping you, get it kind of installed a little bit, and then you can adjust your clamps. But we're showing you, for this boat, this is about where they need to be. So here's what we're gonna do. Paul's helping me outside. I'm gonna hand this to him. We're gonna pull out the main clamp here, and we're gonna push this, lock this into place right there. And now I'll hold this, and we're gonna get ready to install the next section. Or do we want to do the arms first? I guess we can do the arms first. So what we'll do is, why don't you hand me the shortest one? We'll do that. I'll switch with you, Paul. And these are adjustable, and they're highly adjustable. But what we're gonna do is, we're gonna bring this one down. Do you have the screw for that one? Paul's got the screw. We're gonna, this one get screwed in, the one down there where he's working with the Allen key that we supply. And then now this one is gonna go to this lower clamp right here. Now, this takes a little of getting used to, but we've kind of already figured out where they go, where exactly to put them so they miss this arm and for the top one. So now the longer one, which I told you, you'll go ahead and roll all the way out to the dimple, but then come back in an inch and a half. We're gonna put that in. I'll let Paul get his in first. Like that. Now, just so you know, this clamp, that clamp, this clamp, this clamp, and this clamp will actually stay on. Actually, I'll talk about this clamp. When you fold this tower down, this clamp, you're gonna have to loosen and allow it to spin forward just a little bit. But this clamp, and these two four smaller clamps will always stay on. Once you put them on, you don't have to put them on again. And so now all I'm gonna do is adjust this. If for some reason they don't match up, these very highly adjustable right here, and we'll snug these up a little right now. And so now we've got these two arms put on. Now you see why I talk about you absolutely want to do this on a dock or a beach is even better if you have that available to you. And now we're ready for the next section, so I'll get outside the boat and I'll talk to you about it from there. Okay, another little tip my buddy Steve here reminded me is that in most boom installations you'd never want to pull to the ramp, put on your boom and back in, because it probably hit the guides in the back of the trailer. Actually, because of the MasterCrafts ZFT4 tower, or a similar like a G3 tower, you actually could put this on first as long as you were sure that you weren't going to hit anything on the side, because the back of the trailer is going to go down. So you actually could put this first section on the boat ramp as long as you knew your surroundings really well and have this on, and then you could put the next section on at the dock. So just a little quick tip for you, hope that helps. Now we're gonna go outside the boat and we'll put the next section on. Okay, now we're getting ready here. This is the last section. This is a solid aircraft aluminum. We've got two cables, and then we've got a cable protector that comes with it, and the carabiner, and I'm gonna go over the Z-block when we get in the front. But a real important thing you gotta realize here is what we're gonna do is I'm gonna put this section in, make sure it's got a little pop up there, which is kind of hard to get from this angle, but bottom line is you put it in there, line it up, and I'd almost have to have a ladder to hit that right. Hold on, let me set it down. Did that last time. We'll put that, I'll adjust that later. So here we go. We've got our cables facing forward. This section, you want to have it locked into here. That pin, I can feel it right there, but I'd have to get up and see it to get it to actually click. But it pops in right there. Now, one thing I want to talk about this, Steve, you're gonna have to shoot it from here. I want to show you something, because this is really important. A lot of people don't understand. As these boats have gotten bigger and bigger, there's a lot of chine spray, and I've got an article about it that you talked about it on thefootersedge.com, but this chine spray coming off here is so powerful that if you don't get the skier out in front of it, it is really aggravating. So what we do is, and especially with this tower boom, the MasterCrafts ZFT4 tower boom, is notice the angle that we've got this tower boom. Here's the boom clamp here, here's the end of the boom. A lot of people get nervous about that because they're like, hey, wait a minute, no, I want a perfect right angle. No, you do not want to do that. You always want to have the tower boom or any boom angled at least 15 degrees forward. This one we've got it a little more forward because of this particular tower, but this is going to get the skier out of the spray. Now, some of you might be thinking, hey, what about their hands might not be even? Now, you got to realize this is not the water height. This wouldn't be above my head. I've actually got this slightly angled down, which is very adjustable. You'd have to do it on the dock, to get this angle down for a little kid. So if you got a little kid in the water, this would be about the right height for it. You can adjust it up. You want chest to head height for most water skiers, wakeboarders, slalomers. For barefooters, you might even want it above your head. We love to have the tower boom high, especially when you go off a rope. But don't worry at all about this forward angle, because when a skier's on here, they don't even notice it. It's not a big, it doesn't turn them sideways. The kids will absolutely love it because this super solid structure just allows them to get up and out of the water at super slow speeds right next to the driver. Look, driver's right next to you, so you can talk to him. So again, this forward angle, absolutely critical. Here's where the boom clamp is, and look, we're at least 3 feet ahead of that right here to get the skier out of the spray. So the next section we're going to talk about, and we went ahead and save you the trouble here just for time, is this cable. You can slide this cable protector out, and the next section, here's, you got all this cable, this extra cable that comes with it. Don't worry about it. Definitely do not cut it. You want to fold it over. But this Z block right here is critical. What you'll do is you'll put the two cables through there and then loop them around. You want about a 2 to 3 inch loop right here. Your carabiner slips right over that. And then once you get the distance right, which I'm going to show you how to do, is four Allen keys here, Allen screws there, four there. They have to be super, super tight. But how do you figure out the right length? This is what I'm going to show you. So what we're going to do is, we have to have someone push on that, because if you notice, look, I've already adjusted this. If you have your cable set up where you could, here's another thing. Okay, we're talking about a pickle fork design here on this MasterCraft, or any pickle fork. Normally, we take our boom cables and we put them down below here to the U-bolt underneath where you attach it on the trailer or a normal boom. But with a pickle fork design, you do not want to ever bend those cables, have them go around a corner. It will beat up the side of the boat, plus it's not good for the cable. So what we do is we use this pop-out cleat right here, which is plenty strong. But notice, I've set this up to the right length already. Is what we did, now push on a little, Paul, is now I'm going to hook it up. Now we let go. Look at this, guitar string tight all the way back. We've already adjusted that. Once you've got that right to where you can't, it's very tight to get this on. If you can do it by yourself, it's not tight enough. Then what you want to do is tighten those up with a 2-inch loop right here. Then with this extra cable, like I said, do not cut this, because it could cause problems. They're rubber coated to protect them to last long. All you need to do is just shove this through here. You can duct tape them, to itself like these. There's so much left over here that I'm not going to take the time to do it now. But what you do is you pull this all the way through. Then you'd pull it back in there again, and then you probably duct tape them where they're at so that they're not showing. And that's easy enough to do. I'm not going to take the time to do it for this installation, but that's basically what you do. Now, once you see that this is super tight, you could not get that off on your own, you tighten this up. Here's the Velcro for this thing. All you got to do is slip this over the Z block and loop it in. You could actually loop it through this here if you want, or you could do it through the carabiner, and you're good to go. Actually, I think with this application, I'd run it through to here to make sure it covers that Z block, staying out of the way. So there you are, super tight. Look at this. Again, these cables have to be tight. If they got a bunch of slack in them, it is not set up right. Look how tight those are. Very, very tight. It's very important now, at this stage of the game, we actually went through and found the right distances for these clamps. But if for some reason you're trying to get it figured out, this is where you can loosen these up, make some last minute adjustments here, and then tighten everything up. After this thing's totally set up, it is imperative that you go around and tighten all these little Allen bolts. What do you call those bolts, Steve?
Socket head cap screws.
Socket head cap screws. That's what I got, Steve, here. So what you want to do is you got to go around and look. There's four of them here. There's four more here. There's two there that those have to be. I mean, everything's got to be tight. And then you've got four and four up there. You've got eight on the Z block up front. You have to take the time to make sure every single one of those is super tight, because that is critical to skiing safely on this. But once you're set up like this, you are ready to rock and roll. See, notice I got this at a slight downward angle. We've got it angled forward to get the kids and skiers out of the spray or barefooters. Because trust me, if you had this thing back over here, you'd be in so much chine spray, you would be hating life. You want this thing out and forward. And then, like I said, it's not a problem holding on with the hands. And when you put a rope on, it's awesome. You're clean and clear out of the way of a 5-foot rope right on there. So you got everything tied up. We've got this slightly angled down for kids. Let's say you wanted to pull adults and you want it higher. All you got to do is pop those two pins on the top, shorten up those arms, get it the right height that you want it. You'd need to do that on a dock or on a beach. And or you could do it if on the boat trailer if you want. And then you're good to go and it's all set up. So that's pretty much it. Have I forgotten anything, Steve?
I think you got it.
I think I got it. So this is, again, the setup for kids right here. This your kids will absolutely love this. This tower boom, once it's set up properly, will last as long as your MasterCraft will if you take care of it, just like anything if you take care of it. But this is going to be a great investment. Your kids will be able to learn to water ski, wakeboard, slalom, and barefoot water ski without falling. Not just by using the boom. We've got all those free videos for you. Now, if you've got a different type of boat or you're still not sure which one you need, right below this video is a link. Click on the link. Leave us your name, and there's a form there on our site. Leave us your name, your email, which boat, model, make, and year you got, and we'll tell you exactly which boom you need. We'll send you a quote with it, and we've got like $100-something of freebies that we'll give to you as well. If you need, and let me explain something to you. The biggest thing on the internet nowadays is you really don't know who you can trust, right? How do you know you can trust me from anyone else? Words can't cut it. Actions cut it. One thing that we've found is no matter who you buy from, even if you don't buy from me, the one thing that we're dedicated to is we want to add massive value to you. Even if you don't buy stuff from us, we want to help you with whatever you need as far as lessons, water, you know, free stuff that we'll give you, free videos to help you learn or talk to you on the phone to help you solve the problem, because we know that you are the center of influence for your area. I personally believe that every person that you take care of, when you're taking care of one person, you are taking care of 250 people, because that's how much influence we know you have. So we want to make sure you're happy, you're safe, and you're set up. So anyway, feel free to contact us. I'll also have a 24-hour toll-free recorded message you can listen to if you don't want to talk to anybody. Or you can click on the link below the video, leave us your information. God bless you. We're expecting a miracle for you.